has about 2.4 kilowatts of drag on the unit. This is because the alternator is producing 110 amps times, let's say, 12 volts equals about 1,320 watts of electrical output. But the alternator is obviously not 100% efficient, mate. And neither is the serpentine belt driving, although those serpentine belts are pretty good. The system is about, let's call it, 55% efficient typically, and 1320 watts divided by 55% equals 2.4 kilowatts. In other words, the engine needs to deliver 2.4 kilowatts to the alternator for the alternator to pump out 1320 watts of electricity at its peak capacity, because you don't get anything for free and you don't even break even. That's what thermodynamics basically says. And one of the things that smart alternators do is not do all of that 110 amp maximum pumping out at idle, because it would severely impact the idle state. Many vans also have a TV, outdoor light, radio, microwave, laptop, etc. We aren't living in the dark ages, people are dead. That means the Jeep cycles are likely to be half more drained by the morning on any given stop.
Yeah, agreed.
So let's say your 120 amp hour battery is half drained overnight and the charging circuit demands, I don't know, 10 amps from the vehicle, that's a certain charging load. So you need to pump 60 amp hours into the battery to fully recharge it, okay? That's 6 hours running at 10 amps on the highway, or a modest rooftop solar panel.
Well, I generally like your channel. I fail to understand why you belittle people asking questions of you in quite a polite manner, regardless of how bad the questions are. Do you get off on that behaviour?
Yeah, I do. I get right off on it. I mean, you're stupid when you come to space for enough. I don't know why. Probably because it's actually not okay to be a complete dickhead if you're a grown man. That's definitely got something to do with it. Australia is already overstocked on grown-up dickheads, I think you'd agree, and which you might have noticed, especially recently. Scientific illiteracy is in plague proportion, which is evidenced by all of the zombie apocalypse people buying all that toilet tissue right now. What exactly is the benefit?
Johnny should be encouraging scientific experimentation and not mucking it. 100 watts, you say. Maybe you forgot about the rice cooker and don't forget the oven is on because they're cooking the roast.